the scholars I saw, they expect to see and rose on the best day, the glass of passion and the mold of form. The observed of all of them was quite dull. And I, of all ladies, most dejected and wretched, that sucked the honey out of his music bows. Now see that noble and most sovereign reason, like sweet bells jangle out of time and harsh that unmatched form. Nature of blown you blasted of ecstasy. Oh, is he? They have seen what I have seen, see what I see.
Love, his affections do not that way tend, nor what he spake, though it lacked form a little, was not like madness. There's something in his soul, o'er which his melancholy sits on brood, and I do doubt the hatch and the disclose will be some danger, which for to prevent I have in quick determination, thus set it down, he shall with speed to England, for the demand of our neglected tribute. Haply the seas and countries different, with variable objects, shall expel this something settled matter in his heart. Whereon his spring still breathing puts him thus from fashion of himself. What think you on it?
He shall do well, but yet I do believe the origin and commencement of his grief sprung from neglected love. How now, Ophelia? You need not tell us what Lord Hamlet said. We heard it all. My lord, do as you please, but if you hold it fit after this way, let his queen mother all the world entreat him to show his grief. Let her be round with him, and I'll be placed to please you in the ear of all their comforts. If she finds him not, to England send him, or confine him where he was the best chance.
It shall be so. Madness and great ones must not.